Rolling in 3, 2, 1.
We're already recording.
Whoops, you are right.
Well then, good morning and welcome back to the Blue Devil broadcast. I'm Casey.
And I'm Sam. We have an amazing episode in store for...
Wait, I'm not Casey, and why are we even here?
We are taking over the broadcast today. Not sure how I feel about it. Have to live up to all the broadcasting anchors who run this studio.
Well, in that case, I'm Miss Merget.
And I'm Miss Canino. It's weird in the studio, right?
Agreed. If you guys saw me right now with this green screen behind me, you wouldn't even know where I was.
Well, Miss Merget, this is what a studio is supposed to look like.
I guess you're right. This could also double as a recording studio. I can record my new song that I can sing at K-Factor.
Speaking of K-Factor, Key Club had a big turnout for their auditions in preparation for the big talent show May 17th. I know you guys are upset I will not be performing, but...
Don't worry, Canino. I don't think anyone is. We all know I was the real star 2 years ago.
Well, honestly, I think you are just a fan. But anyways, there will be so many talented students to be chosen to perform in such a fun talent show in the next couple of weeks. Hope to see you there. Hopefully there will be some good food.
Speaking of food, I just heard about the amazing meals that are being served in the cafeteria, and Graz got to try out the baked potato bar for the first time ever. Let's take a look.
We have baked potatoes. There's not a potato that I don't like.
Hi, Helen. How are you?
She's always so happy and smiley. This is Helen. She's going to give me my favorite baked potato.
Helen, I'm going to take bacon. We're going to do a little bacon.
First the bacon?
Yeah, whatever you want to give me. A little cheese, a little broccoli. Do we have any sour cream or anything? All right, that's perfect.
You said broccoli, right?
Yeah, good. Nope, no, it's good.
No, hello.
Oh, look at that.
Scrumptious.
Perfect. I got a baked potato, broccoli, a little cheese, and definitely some sour cream. Like I said, there's not a potato that I hate. Let's give this a shot. Delicious. Just like Wendy's. Let's see if broccoli's good. Broccoli's good. Now back to Mrs. Merget and Miss Canino.
Rolling in 3, 2, 1.
Canino.
What?
We're already recording again.
Are we ever going to get this right?
Maybe next time if the broadcasting crew lets us back into the studio, but that depends on how today goes.
True, but out of the studio, I am curious to see what happens in the classrooms throughout the building.
Me too. You're in luck because we have a mini surprise for everyone. Let's sit back, relax, and enjoy the office, Teacher Observation Edition.
Cut!
That's not how it works. You have to give the team a second.
Observations are a way to strike fear in teachers. Me, I'm not worried at all. I eat that up. No cap.
No! No! No!
Oh my gosh, the teacher! Life safety's for losers.
Today, getting observed. All you gotta is shut your mouth. And I'll buy you some munchkins.
I'm sorry.
Only one thing goes wrong during an observation, right? What else could go wrong? All right. So who knows what is the first thing that we need when in the lab? Roy?
First personal protective equipment, sir.
Get out!
Oh man.
A few minutes later.
Mr. Corcoran! Sorry to interrupt, it's an emergency. Faculty bathroom is out of toilet paper. Do you have any?
Hey, Mr. Monroy. Hope to see you next week.
Hopefully it's better than this one.
Well done, Mr. Corcoran, Mr. Monroy, and Mr. Smith, and Mrs. Rossi.
Great job, guys. I'm impressed.
Me too. Wait, Canino.
What?
When is this going to be over? It's so cold in here right now, and I forgot my jacket. Where is the spring weather?
Not sure when it's going to warm up on my part, but I can promise you that Mr. Witt has the answer for you.
Let's take a deeper look into what the weather has in store for us over the spring break.
Next week's weather is not going to be a bright one, everyone. Sunday through Thursday, weather will be partly cloudy, with the highest being 62 and the lowest being 43. Friday being no better, with it being showers, with a high of 60 and a low of 49. Then it's back to the clouds, with the next weekend being partly cloudy, with the highest being 61 and the lowest of 48. Now I think either the clouds want to ruin our spring break or the sun needs a break from us, but whatever the case may be, keep your jackets on and enjoy the indoors, because those clouds aren't going to let us enjoy our time off. I'm Mr. Witt, and this has been the weather. Back to the studio.
Thank you, Mr. Witt. It's finally getting warmer as we approach the end of the year.
Speaking of, we had some crazy natural phenomena recently. First, an earthquake, then a solar eclipse.
I'm no science teacher, but the festivities held here during the eclipse seemed like a really fun time outside.
I think they were out of this world. Moving on, though. Happy fourth quarter. Make it the best quarter yet and finish strong as we get closer to the summer every day.
Wait, Miss Marquette, when is the first day of summer, and how many days until summer break?
Save any questions you want to ask for Mrs. Anson. Many students around the building had questions for Mrs. Anson all about all sorts of topics, and let's take a look and see what advice she has to bring to the table.
Let's take a look.
Welcome to Anson Answers. Today we have a few questions. For our first question, what do you wish you knew when applying to college? I wish I knew exactly what each college was looking for in their candidates. Our second question is, how do I become successful? I think you should always work hard, follow your dreams, and be passionate about what you do. And then for our last question, should I work for money or do what I love? I think it's best to work in an area that you love the most. It makes it easier to get up every day and go to work rather than money. Not that money isn't important. Thank you for watching. Now send it back to Ms. Marquette and Ms. Canino.
Thank you, Ms. Anson, for all of your great advice.
Agreed. You know what, Ms. Marquette?
What?
Did you know lemons float and limes sink?
I did not.
Mr. Wagner taught me that one. Let's send it to him now for some more fun facts.
Hello, welcome to Wagner's Wacky Facts. Did you know your brain is constantly eating itself? Or bananas are radioactive? How about the largest pizza ever created was 13,580 square feet? Oh, and the longest anyone has ever held their breath underwater is over 24 and a half minutes. Did you also know that the fear of long words is called hippopotamonstrosesquipedalophobia? Oh, sorry, got too excited. I think that's enough for today. Have a good day. Bye.
We are getting really good at this anchor stuff. I really think we proved ourselves.
I agree, but unfortunately, that's a wrap for this episode. Thank you to all the teachers who made this episode so amazing.
I'm Miss Canino.
And I'm Miss Marquette, and we'll see you soon.
Bye, Blue Devils.
Oh, yeah. We killed it.
Yep. Nice. Absolutely. Put